is the first night of Navaratri. And this night, and this day, the coming day after this, is dedicated to the feminine nature of the Divine, Durga, Lakshmi and Saraswati, are used as the symbols of these three dimensions of the feminine. They also represent the three basic qualities of existence: tamas, rajas and sattva. Tamas literally means inertia. Rajas means activity, passion. Sattva, in a way, is breaking of boundaries, dissolution, melting and merging. Among the three celestial objects to which the very making of our bodies are very deeply connected, the earth, the sun and the moon, Mother Earth is considered tamas. The sun is rajas, moon is sattva. Those who aspire for power, for immortality, for strength, they will worship those forms of feminine which are referred to as tamas, like the Kali or the Mother Earth. Those who aspire for wealth, for passion, for life, and various other gifts that the material world has to offer, they naturally aspire towards that form of the feminine which is referred to as a Lakshmi or the sun. Those who aspire for knowledge, knowing, transcendence, immortality of not the body, but transcending the limitations of the mortal body, they will aspire for that aspect of the feminine which is referred to as the sattva, or Saraswati is the representative of that, or the moon. So, these 3 days are the days of the feminine, for those of you who are not aware of this. The Linga Bhairavi has been consecrated with 3 basic chakras to represent these three dimensions of tamas, rajas and sattva. Tamas is the nature of the earth, and today is her day, and she is the one who gives birth the whole the gestation period that we spend in the womb, our womb time, is tamas. It's like a state which is almost like hibernation, but it's growing. So tamas is the nature of the earth, of your birth. The moment you come out, then you start activity, rajas begins. If you are aware enough or fortunate enough, sattva will touch you. Otherwise, the color of rajas. It's good as long as the going is good. When the going gets bad, rajas is going to be super bad. So what was absolute inertia now has become a dynamic rajas. This may transcend or may again go back to the same thing. Durga Lakshmi, Durga Lakshmi, Durga Lakshmi… Abdi pair vechirukingala yaro Durga Lakshmi ni? Avaru moonranga. Durga Lakshmi, Durga Lakshmi, Saraswati never happened. That means you are in the cycle, you are in the trap of life and death, life and death, life and death. Transcendence is yet to come. So these two will anyway happen. What is in a state of inertia will get into a state of rajas and activity. And again fall back and become inertia for a certain period of time and again get back into activity. This is happening to you as an individual. This is happening to the planet. This is happening to the galaxy. This is happening to the whole cosmos. It goes into a state of inertia and then becomes dynamic and again goes into a state of inertia. But the important thing is, this one has the capability to break the cycle and transcend. So these three dimensions of the Devi are enshrined in the form of Bhairavi or Linga Bhairavi. So these 3 days, you must be able to draw these three dimensions of existence and sustenance for yourself, because you need all these three. The first two are needed for your survival and well-being. The third is an aspiration to go beyond. So, these 9 days, above all, to approach every aspect of life in a celebratory way, this is most important. If you approach everything in a celebratory way, you learn to be non-serious about life, but absolutely involved. The problem with most human beings right now is, if they think something is important, they will become dead serious about it. If they think it is not so important, they will become lax about it. They don't show the necessary involvement. If you are serious, avar romba serious a irukranga na en artham adathapadi. You know, in Tamil language or even in English probably, he's in a very serious condition means next step you know where. And lot of people are in a serious condition. There's only one thing that's going to happen to them which is of any significance. Rest will bypass them, because anything that they think is not serious, they are unable to show involvement and dedication towards that. That's the whole problem. The passage, the secret of life is in this, seeing everything with a non-serious eye, but absolutely involved, like a game. That's the reason most profound aspects of life are approached in a celebratory way, so that you don't miss the point.